Hi, I'm Chip Ward with the Mississippi Department of Wildlife, Fisheries, and Parks, and today I'm with the Nature Conservancy at Camp Shelby, where they're releasing gopher tortoises back into the wild.
What we're currently doing is, in this building, we're head starting gopher tortoises, so we're raising them up at a faster rate than what they would grow in the wild, and we're planning on turning loose 89 head started 2 year olds. So this is a head started or raised in this building 2 year old, and this is a wild 3 year old. So as you can see, you know, the head started individual is much larger in size. Larger size equates to better chances of surviving. The gopher tortoise is a longleaf pine specialist, so the longleaf pine ecosystem once ranged from South Carolina down about halfway into Florida and then west into Louisiana, and that's where tortoises live, and that's the only place where they live. Since European settlement, that habitat type has been lost by 95%, maybe as high as 98%. So gopher tortoises, for those people that don't know, they're a tortoise, not a turtle, so they live on land. They excavate a burrow that around here is anywhere from 25 to about 30 feet long. Over in Florida, they can be as long as 80 feet. And they're considered a keystone species, so like an old Roman archway. You have that one centric stone in the middle. If you remove that, whole thing will crumble down the archway. Over 360 different animals use their burrows. So if you lose the gopher tortoise burrow, you potentially could lose these other species as well. So if an individual comes across a gopher tortoise in the wild, they should just leave it alone. They can sit back from afar and watch its behavior, maybe follow it to its burrow. If the tortoise is in an area that appears like it could be in jeopardy, they should contact the Mississippi Department of Wildlife, Fisheries, and Parks, or the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service, so that animal can be taken out of the potential danger.